guys, what's up? It's me, Aarti, on the 90 Day YouTube Challenge. And today I'm going to talk about this amazing book that I finished reading just last night. It's called Daring Greatly by Brene Brown. Now, this is what happens with me whenever I find something new and really interesting and it helps me in a very weird way. I just feel like that need or urge to share it with everybody around me because that book was so insightful, so amazing, and I think it can benefit so many others. So this is my effort to talk about it. Before that, Brene Brown is somebody I've been wanting to talk about since the beginning of me doing these videos, you know, me starting this channel. I stumbled on Brene Brown through social media, and on days like these, now I'm extremely grateful and thankful for social media, you know, on stumbling at just the right things at the right time. I think this has been one of those things for me. I ended up googling her, and then I stumbled on one of her talks on YouTube, which is called The Power of Vulnerability. Now, for somebody like me, that word vulnerability drew me towards it, and I ended up watching that video, and from that video on, there has been no looking back. I have literally watched her videos back to back. I was binge watching Brene Brown at a point of time. I'm going to say that without, you know, any shame. I'm going to put a link of that video in the description below. For those of you all who are completely new here, Brene Brown is a researcher who researches human emotions like shame, courage, empathy, and has written a lot of books about them. I finally got my hands on Daring Greatly. I ordered it on Amazon very recently and I finished reading this. I think this was my quickest read ever. And I can't begin to tell you what an amazing, eye-opening, insightful, I mean, this book was just everything for me. Now, for those of y'all thinking we don't like self-help books, let me tell you all, this is not just any self-help book. It is literally like somebody getting into the deepest, darkest corners of the human mind, like with a flashlight on, and, you know, throwing light on all those deep, dark corners that we are somewhere, you know, afraid to go to or to come face to face with. So this book is exactly that. It shows, you know, how we are wired as human beings, how we function and behave and react to certain things the way we do and why we do that. And I think somewhere down the line, when we understand the whys behind certain things, of why were we doing it, there's a bigger chance of us going back, fixing those things and changing them, right? Now, getting straight to the point, who is this book for? This book is for anybody who is a leader, a parent, a teacher, a wife, a husband, an actor, a politician, anybody and everybody here. Why should you read Daring Greatly? Now, if you have been one of those people in life like me who has, you know, battled the issue of vulnerability, being too much, feeling too much, of people or friends constantly telling you, why are you being so sensitive? Why are you being so touchy about things? Why do you have to feel so much? If you have at ever any point of time felt these things, this book is for you. If you have at any point of time felt, I don't do vulnerability, this book, my friend, is definitely for you, because as humans, there's none of us who doesn't do vulnerability. We all do it in different ways than the others. And this book busts the biggest myths that all of us, most of us, have grown up listening to, that vulnerability is weakness. No, it's not. It's a huge power of strength. It's the place, it's the birthplace of innovation, courage, creativity, and just everything we know. So this book is going to change, you know, shift that entire perspective for you guys. If you have at some point or the other struggled about your worthiness, this book is definitely for you. Now, we can all be very cool about things and say, oh, I haven't struggled with my worthiness and all of that, but that's not true. We can only lie to ourselves, because all of us at some point or the other in our lives have gone through that struggle. The struggle of I'm not enough, the struggle of not feeling worthy enough for some people, for a certain position in life. And it's surprising to see how the sense of low self-esteem or sense of unworthiness is actually the underlying trouble in all of our day-to-day life problems. If you are somebody who struggled with shame, who has childhood stories of shaming, who has been brought up in a family where, you know, shaming each other is the culture, or who are currently present at a workplace where shaming and blaming and not taking accountability for your actions is the culture right now, or if you have been somebody who's used shaming as a way to change the behavior of a kid in the classroom or at home or a spouse or an employee in your office, this book is definitely for you. So those are the reasons why you must read this book. Now, there have been some amazing learnings for me from Daring Greatly, which I really want to share with you guys. Like I said earlier, you know, this book has struck a huge chord with me. It's going to be one of those bedside books for me now that I'm going to keep going back to every now and then. So the first thing that stuck with me is Brene says, connection is why we are here. As human beings, we are wired for connection. And to experience connection and belonging in its true form, we need to embrace vulnerability in each and every way possible. And I think that's where the fuck up is. The way we're conditioned, the way we've grown up, embracing vulnerability is not you know, is seen as something awkward, something shameful, something that we are supposed to be ashamed of, and not everybody is, you know, mature enough or is or knows how to handle it. And even for those who, you know, are vulnerable, it's not a very comfortable experience. It's about being naked about everything you're feeling in front of somebody you could be close to, or sometimes to an audience while you're performing in a play. But that's where our working on ourselves comes into picture. She says, because we are not comfortable with embracing vulnerability, we most of the times try to numb it. Now, there are many ways that we try to numb it in. Trying to be too busy with work all the time. Oh my God, I'm so like immersed in work and soaked in work. I can't tell you. That is a way of getting away and running from your emotions and life's problems. And we do that unknowingly so many times. I have done it in the past. And then, of course, there are addictions. There's drinking, there's smoking, there's drugs, and there's I don't know what not. That people do to just get that escape and not face their emotions and fears head on. But this one learning that I took from this book has like just changed everything for me, is we can't numb selectively. Because when we numb shame, grief, fear, disappointment, we are also numbing the other emotions like happiness, joy, gratitude. So basically, a lot of learnings out there, a lot of insights, huge revelations on each and every emotion that I understood in a totally different light after reading Daring Greatly. So if you guys have felt any of these emotions that I spoke about today, please go and pick up a copy of this book like right today. And apart from this, you know, above everything else that I related with in this book, there's this one thing which was like bang on for me. The whole quote by Theodore Roosevelt, the quote is very popularly called Man in the Arena. Basically, the name of the book, Daring Greatly, is taken from the quote. And I'm going to read that quote for you. I think it has just changed everything for me, being from a field of art myself. Like, I've been a radio jockey before, I've worked in television creatives, I still do. I have been a part of theater before, I've performed in front of an audience. For everybody out there who's an artist or who's creating in some way or the other, be it, you know, you're a painter or you're making music or you're public speaking or you're an actor, whatever you are, trust me, what this book is going to give you in terms of your career, in terms of how much you can contribute to your career, in terms of creating more of what you're creating, is going to be life-changing. You definitely need to read this before going. It says, it's not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who's actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, because there's no effort without error and shortcoming. But who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly. Isn't that quote something like it just changes everything for you? So if you are artists out there, or if you're creating in any way in the world out there, please go and buy this book right today, guys. So on that note, I'm going to take off. If you guys happen to take my word for it, go buy this book and happen to read it and like it, please do share your stories with me, your stories of how you related to it. I would love to hear them from you guys. Also, I haven't said it before, but I think it's high time I start saying it. Please like and subscribe this video if you have liked it and if you thought this was relatable, and please keep coming back for more such content right here. See you.